Hello, I'm Deb Erney from deberney.com, and today I'm going to try to show you how to use the different outputs on your mixer. It can be really confusing. This mixer has three different outputs. It's got the main mix, it's got Alt 3, 4 mix, and then it's got the control room, which I can choose to put out the main mix through or the alt mix through, or I can combine them. Typically, what you would use these for is to send different mixes to band members. Say I wanted to hear myself with guitar and vocal on Alt 3, 4, and another band member I could set up to hear themselves on the main mix. And I can set their volume so that they can be any way that they want to hear them, and then I can set the output to go together and send that out to the audience. So I'm going to show you what I'm talking about. Your instrument outputs are going to go into the inputs of your mixer. The outputs of your mixer are going to go to the inputs of your sound source. So you're always going to have an in going to an out, an out going to an in. By default, everything is set to going out to the main mix, and you can activate the Alt 3 4 by highlighting, clicking, unclicking, and that will send it to the Alt 3 4 instead of the main mix. And typically, I like to set these left right because I usually use this to record when I'm out playing with a friend. I'll record and I want to have four separate channels. And this will give me four separate channels. I'll set the mixer hard left, hard right for me, for him, hard left, hard right. That way I have vocal guitar for me, left right, vocal guitar for him, left right. I'll route me to the main, him to the Alt 3 4, and that way I can record four separate channels and I can control the volumes. So right now I have this all hooked up to four different outputs so you can hear the differences on these. So right now this is everything going out through the main mix. I've got cellos, left, synth bass, right. Drums left, keyboard right. Okay, I've got everything going out through the mains now. Okay, what I would do for myself, or what you could do for anyone, say the synth and the strings want to hear themselves separately. So you would push so that they're heard on the 3-4 output. And that output would run into their PA system. They could have a mixer, they could have speakers, but the outputs for all 3-4 would run into whatever they want to use to hear themselves. Right now, they've got two channels they're hearing on their own. And now I'll send the drums and the piano want to be heard separately as well, left, right channels, and that's going through the main mix. So now we have two separate mixes, Alt 3 4 main. The next thing you're going to want to do is send it out to your audience. You've got one person's listening to left, right, Alt 3 4, another person's listening to main mix, left, right, and you can control any volume that they want. If they want it loud, they want it soft, however they want it, it can be controlled. Then to go out to the mix that the audience would hear, I would hook up the control room to go out to the audience. So that would go into my PA speakers that everyone would hear. And to do that, by default, it's off. So there I'm adding Alt 3, 4, Now I'm adding the main mix. And I can adjust that any volume I want. And that's what the audience would hear. So that's how you run separate mixes. That's how you would use the different outputs. Now, if I wanted to switch these, say that would be 3/4, I could do that. So whatever I push for that 3/4 is what's going to be running into that 3/4 channel. And whatever is left is going through the main mix. So there you go. That's how you can record with four channels coming out of your mixer. Say you're trying to do a live podcast or something, all you would do is plug in your microphone into your mixer, and then in that case, I would use it set to the middle, and then wherever you wanted it to go out, probably your main, because your XLRs are going to be hotter than your quarter inch. So I would set that to go out to my main, and there you go. And that way you'd have a left-right main instead of... And that's how you would run that out. Now you can hook this up USB, but that's a whole different video. I've done a few videos with USB recording with an analog mixer and how to set it up. I also have another one that you might want to check out. It's USB setup for PC and Mac with Studio One. Hopefully this will get you started and help you understand different ways to use your mixer and different ways you can route those outputs. If you appreciated this video and it helped you out, I'm happy to be of service, but please like, share, and subscribe. That helps me out. Thank you so much. Bye.